I want to tell you about how to cut and dry your herbs. We have an Aero Garden in our house with herbs in it, and we get so many herbs that we cannot use them. So what we do is we cut them when we can't use them and we dry them. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. There's a couple different ways. There's a way that you can cut them and you can hang them, which is very simple. Or you can cut them and dry them on a dehydrator. I'm trying to find my scissors. So I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that today with cutting and drying your herbs at your house. Because you see all the time that you can buy herbs from the store, but how exactly do you maintain them or help them to last longer so that you can use them? So I'm gonna show you our Aero Garden right now. We have a few herbs that are still producing really well. So we have some chives right here. And we just harvested these like a couple weeks ago, so they're just small again. We have lots of parsley. This is all parsley right here. So I need to harvest that. You can see underneath here how there is stems that have been cut, but this parsley is still growing. This right here is Thai basil, and we just cut that a couple weeks ago, but it's a heavy producer, so it produces a lot and fast. And then over here we have our curly parsley. And curly parsley is another heavy producer, so we've cut that a couple weeks ago and it's already produced a lot more. Down here is our thyme, and we just harvested all of our thyme, so we don't have any, we just have a couple little sprigs. And then back here we have our regular basil. It's hard to see because of all the curly parsley. We have our regular basil back here, and I'll harvest some of that today to get some more growth. We just harvested that a couple weeks ago too. So right here we don't have anything. Right now we did have dill, and we had so much dill that we couldn't deal with it. We had so much dill that we just stopped growing it because we don't eat dill very much. So we just dried it all. So now I'm gonna show you how to cut these herbs so that you can use them and dry them and use them later. You can use them fresh and put them in a cup of water, or you can dry them and use them anytime you want. So here we go. I'm gonna try to do this one-handed. Okay, so right here we have our curly parsley. Do you see how the leaves kind of curl at the end? That's why it's called curly parsley. So we're just gonna come down where however long we think we want it, and we just cut it. Just cut it off, put it to the side. It smells so good. And we'll just cut that. And this grows really fast. You never want to cut more than, I would say, a third to two-thirds of your plant, because that will keep, it'll keep producing if you don't do that. So, but these are getting in the way, and we have so much already, I don't need them. I'm just going to go ahead and cut them. So, got all that. And now these really heavy ones, there we go. So now we'll gather up my parsley. My parsley stems have all that right here, see? And then we can dry that. And then I'm gonna do my other parsley back here, because that is a very big producer. And I'm gonna cut off some of that. These big ones that weigh a lot kind of weigh down the rest of them. Sometimes they get in the way, so I like to cut those off. It smells amazing. This is so good to use, like on your, I love it on my eggs. I love thyme on my eggs too. And chives are really good too. Okay, so we'll do a couple more. We have, this one definitely produces more than all of our other herbs. the leaves are also a lot bigger too. So, and then we're gonna go back here to, well, let me show you how much parsley I just got off of that. Just got all of that parsley. So, and then we're gonna go back here to our Thai basil.